So, Dr. Vijaya, now starting with our session, the very first thing, which I would want you to brief our audience a little bit about is when we say natural birth, when we use this term natural birth, what do we mean by that? Because whenever we say this term natural birth, we automatically associate with it normal delivery. Is that what is it about, or there is more to it? It would be great if you can shed some light on that.
Definitely. I think the fact is that we have forgotten that our grandmothers gave birth naturally all the time. Our grandmothers and great-grandmothers did that all the time. I think once the birth shifted from home and being in the safety of home into the hospitals, where suddenly it was like somebody had to deliver the mother rather than the mother give birth to a baby, all these different categories have started, like what is normal, what is natural, how do you, think about these in a different perspective. But essentially, the way I talk about natural birth is that it is a process that is started by your body. It's for your body. It give the body has its own resources in terms of starting labor, in terms of progressing labor, in terms of giving the right amount of hormones at the right time. It's a symphony of hormone that comes into the mother and thereby to the baby. See, we always talk of mother-baby as a dyad. It's not just what is happening to mom, it's also what is happening to the baby, right? So if you look at it in that sense, then all the hormones that go through mom are also going to go through to baby. And baby is an active partner in it. Somehow in our society, until the baby is born, we keep saying mother, 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 mother. And after the baby is born, we say baby, baby, baby. And in that aspect, we have forgotten that they're always going to be a dyad, right? So I think the idea behind, a natural birth is one that is started by the body, progressed by the body, where the mother is in charge. She births a baby. There are little, if not any, interventions. And then the baby is, welcomed into this world as a mammal which needs its mother at birth, right? Not just supported. It's not something like a pizza which is delivered and kept on the table, right? It is like this baby is a part of the mother, honored in that process to be put on the mother. And then the mother-baby dyad have a minute of pause to, sort of soak in that, yes, this enormous transformational event has happened. And that's really what we call as a natural birth. A normal delivery is a vaginal birth. Now, at the outset, I just want to say something to all the people who are listening in here. We want to honor every mother, whichever way that she has birthed, right? We don't want mothers to feel that, somehow they did something wrong or they did something, that something was lacking simply because they birthed a certain way or another. Given these constraints, we are trying to spread the word, but every woman is heroic in the way that she has birthed. Whether it's a normal delivery, whether it is with an episiotomy, whether it is by induction, whether it is by cesarean section, which is an abdominal birth, every woman is heroic, and I just want to say we honor all of them, and it is not that one is better than the other or other is better than one, but we should be looking at essentially helping the mother and baby in the most gentle way as possible that nature has already intended. So I just wanted to get that out of the way because people here should not feel that if we are standing on one leg and this is how it should be, there is nothing that it should be. It is what that mother and that baby need, right? So back to the normal delivery. It is something that may have started on its own and then have been hastened with hormonal, synthetic hormones. It may have been one where it started on its own, but the bag of waters was broken. It may have been something that the care provider, without really giving consent, see, that's the other thing too. There is not a whole lot of consent that is happening in this space because there is literally no other profession which would touch the mother without A, asking her permission and informing her, right? But this happens all the time, and it is almost like we have heard such stories of vulnerable women saying, I was pushed, I was prodded, I was told, if you cannot open your legs, for this, why did you get even pregnant? So all these things should not happen. Beside that point, if the woman's bag of waters has been broken, or for example, her cervix has been stripped ahead of time to try to get the labor started, all of these things can happen. And at the end, if somebody else is essentially is in charge, they are around the mother telling her when to push, telling her how to push. Maybe an episiotomy has been given. Maybe there has been an instrumental birth. All that can still be a part of normal birth, right?
Of course.
But there is very, very little natural about it. You can have an epidural. All these things can happen. But it's still a normal delivery. It still has its benefits for mother and baby compared to a cesarean section. But you also have to understand and ask the mother, how did you feel? How did the care providers make you feel? How did the people who are supporting you make you feel, right? So I think those are the aspects that we want to you know, sort of talk about when you talk about natural birth. Now, I would associate a natural birth also with a gentle birth. Okay, and what is a gentle birth? Gentle birth is where the mother has respect, she has privacy, she feels safe, she feels loved and cared for by the people surrounding her. She feels at peace knowing that someone is there to keep track of her. Someone is there to watch her. Someone is there to make sure that she and baby are well. But she's very peaceful, right? Very little disturbance. And then honoring that mother and baby at the moment of birth, like I talked to you about. And then honoring that the baby at the moment of birth, as well as in the first hour, the golden hour that we talk about, and in the first 2 hours, because it is the first 90 minutes where the baby is really kind of, first few minutes, it's just about acclimatization. Next few minutes is about making sure that there is a beautiful transition from womb life to a newborn circulation, newborn breathing, newborn everything. Then it's about understanding that, yes, this place where I'm put on, I'm hearing the same heartbeat that I heard from inside. I'm hearing the same respirations I heard from inside. I'm hearing that same I'm feeling the warmth of the mother's body that is making me feel comfortable. And then the baby's neuronal imprint of safety, how the baby feels safe, is imprinted in its mind in that first couple of hours of life. So the more we touch, pull, prod, separate, take the baby away, the baby is, and it's like, it first cries, and then it says, well, you know, I am defenseless. And then it sort of shuts down. And you don't want that. You want a baby who is alert, active, thriving, and knowing that there is a circle of love around it at the moment of birth. And that's what a natural, gentle birth should look like.